In this video, we'll try to understand how SQL Server stores and manages data internally. So in order to understand how SQL Server stores data internally, what I've done is I've created a very simple database here called as test123, and it has a very simple table here called as TBL customer, which has just one column called as customer name, which is having a char data type, which is of length 1000. Now, whenever we insert, update or delete data into the TBL customer table or into any table of SQL Server, at the end of the day, all of this data is stored into the MDF file, which is our physical file for our SQL Server. So if you go to your MS SQL data folder in the C program files Microsoft SQL Server, you will find this MDF file which is located in the data folder. So actually there are two kinds of file. One is the MDF file, which is the primary data file, and the other one is the log file, which is the transaction log file. But you know, this process is not so simple. In other words, it is not that if you just write a record or if you just read a record from SQL Server, he just goes to the MDF file and starts reading it straightforward from the MDF file. No. Whenever you read a record or whenever you write a record, he actually writes it on an 8 KB chunk size called as page. So in other words, whenever you insert a row, he will actually send it to that 8 KB chunk size, which is called as a page. Whenever you say you want to read a row, he will actually locate that page, you know, where your data is stored and read it from there. In other words, whatever insert, update or delete you do on a SQL Server table, at the end of the day, they get stored into a 8 KB page. So let's go ahead and let's do a very nice deep dive. And let's see that how this 8 KB page looks like. So what I'll do is, let me go and insert a very simple record into this TBL customer table. So let me go and edit this TBL customer table here. And let me just go and insert, let's insert only one record, okay? And let's try to locate this record into that 8 KB page. So what I'll do is, I'm going to go here and insert one simple record called as record 1. And I would like to go and locate this record 1 into that page, and let me look at, you know, how that page looks like and where is this record one stored. Now before I move ahead and I show this demonstration of how to locate this record inside a page, I would like to talk more about SQL Server data here. Now when we say SQL Server data, you will have different kinds of data, right? For example, the one which you see on your screen is a user data, the data which is actually having business sense, right? And then you can have other data, like for example SQL Server configuration data. Probably you would like to have data which is telling, you know, where exactly your pages are stored. So you can classify SQL Server data into two parts or into two types, I'll say. One which is the user data and the other one which is more of a configuration data or the metadata. Now for different kind of data types, you know, there are different kinds of SQL Server pages. For example, for user defined data, for example this record one data will get stored into something called as a data page, where the actual data of your business gets stored. Okay, when you talk about index structure, it will get stored into something called as index pages. When you talk about where are your pages located, how much memory has been allocated, this kind of system information gets stored into something called as IAM pages. So in other words, different kind of data will have different kind of SQL Server pages. Now there are like 14 different kind of SQL Server pages, but now for this experiment I don't want to go into those 14 pages and explain you, because I want to keep this complete demonstration as simple as possible, right? But in order to understand this demonstration, we still need to know two different kind of pages. The first page is called as the data page. This data page is the page, you know, where actually your SQL Server user data gets stored. And the second page is the IAM page. IAM stands for Index Allocation Map. The IAM pages, they have the information where all the pages of your SQL Server is stored. So they know that, okay, this is the page on this memory allocation it is stored. This much percentage it is full, you know, this many rows it has, and etc. Right? So we at least need to know two pages for this demonstration. One is the data page, where actually your data, that is this record one, will get stored. And second one is the IAM page, which will help us to locate that data page. Now, in order to know that for this DBL customer, what kind of pages are used, what we need to do is we need to use the database console commands. So you can see here, I'm saying here DBCC. DBCC stands for database console command. Please use this command and get me all the indexes, okay, including the pages. So that's why you can see this minus one here. The minus one indicates, you know, not only the indexes but also the normal page like data page, IAM page, etc. Get me those values also, and get me for this database, that is test 1 to 3, and specifically for this table, that is TBL customer. So let me just go and say execute here. So we can see here he has pulled up two records here. In other words, he says that, you know, for this table there are two pages been allocated, and you can see the type of the page. So you can see one is of page type 1 and the other one is of page type 10. This page type 10 is nothing but it's a IAM page, and the page type 1 is a data page. Okay, so if you remember, I have said IAM pages, it has records, you know, which tells you that where exactly your data pages are, right? And this one indicates the data page. So what will happen when anybody goes and says that, okay, get me this TBL customer, or, you know, insert a record into TBL customer? The first thing, he will go and query this IAM page here, and from this IAM page he will go and get that data page, you know, where he will go and store the record. So for example, you can see here this IAM page value is 282, and this 282 is linked with this 281, you know, where you know, this, and this 281 actually indicates your data page. So in other words, for now, this record 1 is stored into this data page here called as 281. So we would like to now go and see that data page, and we would like to see this value record 1 inside it, right? Now again, to see the internals of the page, we need to use the DBCC command. So what we have to say here, DBCC, please on the trace. On the trace means you would like to see all the details of the page on the SQL Server Management Studio itself. The next command is DBCC page. So you want to see the details of the page which is located in this database test 1 to 3. So this is the database test 1 to 3. The page is located in file number 1. So you can see this IAMFID. So the value is 1, and the page ID number is 281. So 1, 281, and the last parameter 1 says that, you know, it actually tells you that till what detail you want to see the page details. If you say 1, you get an overall view. If you say 3, you will get a more detailed view. But for now, 1 will do. And let me go ahead and fire this statement. So let me click on execute here. Now, if you see, the output of the DBCC page is nothing but the full page details. Okay. And the complete page is divided into 3 sections. The first one is the page header. The page header actually tells you, you know, basically what kind of page it is. For example, you can see the type is 1. So 1 means it's a data page. You know, which is the previous page and which is the next page, in case it's an index page, okay, and so on. So the first section, you know, in a SQL Server page is nothing but the page header, okay. The next section which follows is the actual record, okay, or the actual data. So currently, if you remember, in our TBL customer, we had one record, record 1. So just to remind you, if you remember, we had this one row here called as record 1. So you can see now this is the record 1, okay, and it also specifies that this is a primary record. Primary record means it's the actual data, okay. And after the data, you know, there is a row offset. This row offset actually tells you that where exactly this record is lying. So for example, this record 1, you know, which has which actually is lying in the 060 memory. Okay, so you can see here he says that, you know, there is one record which is in 060, right? So basically, you can think about that a SQL Server page is divided into 3 sections. First one is the page header, second one followed by the actual data, and the final one is nothing but the row offset, you know, which basically tells where exactly every row is lying. So now that we know that a page is divided into 3 sections, you know, let's try to analyze, you know, each section gets how much bytes. Okay, so the first thing is, so let me pull up this Excel sheet here and let me explain you, you know, where exactly how much bytes goes in. So the total page size is 8 KB. Okay, so this total page size is in KB here, so that is 8 KB. Very quickly, right? Now 1 KB is 1024 bytes, so the total bytes of a page is 8 into 1024, so that is 8192 bytes, right? Great. And currently we have only one record. So if you remember, our TVL customer just has one record, and this record is of size 1000 bytes. Why? Because this is a char, right? So one char is equal to 1 byte. So basically we have one record and every record is of size 1000 bytes. So let me again go back to my Excel here. So we have record, number of record I'll say. So number of record is 1, right? And per record size is 1000 bytes. So basically the total record size becomes number of records into whatever is the per record size. So that is 1000 for now, right? So I'm just going to save this. Great. And very quickly, I would also like to emphasize, now if you remember, I said the total bytes is char of 1000, right? So in other words, it's 1000 bytes, right? But if you see here, the record size is actually of 1007 bytes. So we have 7 bytes extra, to identify that the column is null or not. So in other words, I would like to also go and add 7 bytes extra here, which is nothing but the overhead, right? Right. So our total page is divided into 3 sections, right? The first one is the page header. The second one is the actual data. So I'll say this is data rows. And the last one is the row offset. Row offset means, you know, it has the address of every record. Now the page header is of 96 bytes. Okay, so irrespective, you know, whatever is the size of number of rows, the page header is always fixed of 96 bytes. So this page header has information regarding the page, right? Data rows is whatever is your total record size. So that means your number of rows into per record size. So that means this is as it is, right? And the row offset is 2 bytes for one record. So you can see that I have one record here. So it is 2 bytes for one record. Remember that row offset actually tells, you know, where exactly each row is located in the, in the page, right? Great. So the total bytes free at this moment is 8192 minus sum of all this, right? So 7087. So if I go back here, so currently I have only one record. So if you see, this is the only one record I have. So you can see here the total free bytes is 7087 here, and you can see 7087 here in the page header section. Great, right? Now if I go and add one more record here very quickly, so let me just go and add one more record here, record 2, right? So if I go and fire this command here, I will also see record 2 over here. So very quickly, if I see here, so this is record 1, that's great. This is record 2, that is great. And for both of these records, we have 2 entries here, you know, which points to both of these records, right? So if I increase the number of records here, so the total bytes free is 6078. Let me just go and verify with the page header section here. So it is 6078. Great, right? But now one of the questions, you know, which will come to your mind is, what happens if you exceed 8 KB page size? In other words, for example, what happens, you know, if this becomes like 6 records, or let's say, you know, 8 records. So if you see 8 records, there are hardly any bytes left out. or must be, if you look at 7 records, there are hardly any bytes left out. So what happens in that case? So very quickly, let me just go and add here, must be 8 records here. So I'm going to go and edit this table. I think already this table is open here. So I'll say record. So this is record 3. So record 4, record 5, record 6, record 7, and record 8. So 8 records we have. So when I say 8 records, you know, I just have 24 bytes left out, right? So if I go and add one more record, let's say record 9, so what should happen, right? So let me again go back here. Okay, and let me run this dbcc ind to see that what happens. So you can see here we have some extra pages now. So this 10 is nothing but the IM page, so that is 282, and this 282 is now pointing towards 2 data page. So you can see 282 is pointing towards 281, and 282 is also pointing towards 283. So what has happened now is, so if you see here, just to quickly first, let's see 281, okay? So in 281, it has record 1, it has record 2, it has record 3, and goes dot 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 till down below 5, 6, and 7, right? 7 records. Now, you know, after 7 records, what has happened is, basically, he has only 1033 bytes free. So in that 1033 bytes, he cannot put the 8th record. So what he has done is, he has created one more data page. So this is this 1283. So in 283, if you see now, if you see in 283, it should start from record 8 and then record 9. So in other words, you know, once your 8 KB page gets full, he will actually create more data page, okay? And then again, you know, that data page is of the same type. In other words, it has the page header, you know, then the rows, and finally at the down below the offsets, right? So let's quickly revise what we have learned. Point number one, SQL Server stores data in pages. Every page is of 8 KB size. Third point, SQL Server divides the page into 3 sections. The first one is a page header, which is of 96 bytes. Followed by the row, you know, which is whatever row bytes it is, and then at the last we have the row offset, you know, which actually points towards where actually the row is located. And the final point, when a page gets filled, he will create new pages to accommodate new rows. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand, you know, how a SQL Server row gets stored internally, what is a page, and the structure of the page. Thank you so much.